2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
An event happening in the Hunter next week is the Cultural Awakenings Festival, and the University of Newcastle, and more specifically the Wollotuka Institute, will be presenting some of the events at that festival. From Wollotuka this morning, Tammy Small joins us in the studio to have a bit of a look through. Tammy, very, very busy, getting very close to the festival date next Tuesday. Good morning.
Good morning. Gawambanya. Welcome. How are you?
I'm very well. So look, how busy is it at Wollotuka at the moment with some of these events that are happening? Everyone run off their feet?
Yeah, look, same at Wollotuka and with the student events team. We work very much in collaboration with a particular event or session throughout the Cultural Awakenings Festival. So, yeah, we're you know, scrambling at the moment. We've got some basket weavers, got some Indigenous food, or, you know, so I think we're getting wattle seed scones. And so
nice.
And some jams.
I don't see any of those.
Lily Pilly jams. Sorry, I couldn't bring you a sample. You'll have to come on Wednesday the 8th.
Go. So, for those who might not be completely aware of some of the work that the Wollotuka Institute is all about, can you just explain typically what your aim is?
Yeah, definitely. So, we're the Wollotuka Institute at the University of Newcastle. So, we're the Indigenous Higher Education Unit, and we look after future students, current students, but we also run our own degrees. So, we currently offer the Bachelor of Global Indigenous Studies, which just started this year. And it's actually, we're really excited about that course. It's primarily online, it seems to be, and we've got Indigenous international guest lectures and speakers from all around the world. So that's really a big one for us. But
you've got to always approach something with a bit of apprehension when it's brand new, isn't it?
First
year, iron out the bugs for a while.
Yeah, that's it. But so the Cultural Awakenings Festival in itself has been run for various years by the University of Newcastle, and Wollotuka usually comes in and we play part in a couple of the events. So on the Tuesday, the 7th of May, for example, in the morning, roughly 11:30 at Civic Park, we lead off with the Parade of Nations, and this is one of the fun event and one of the most entertaining events, I think, to watch in the Cultural Awakenings Festival. So you'll see everybody dressed up in their traditional attire, and they'll be leading a parade through to Civic. So Wollotuka students will be at the front. We've got men's and women's group that they're going to be at the front. They're going to be painted up in their ochre and going to be making a bit of noise. So we're involved in that Parade of Nations.
Oh, sounds pretty good. Because there's a drive-in movie night on Tuesday night. You've got on the Wednesday connecting with Newcastle culture, but then you've got something called immersion on the Wednesday. What's that all about?
This is one of the highlight evening events for this session. This is a community event. So not only does it align with our new future strategic, you know, priorities and plans for community engagement, it also shows and highlights the cultural diversity of the University of Newcastle. We have so many groups and societies, and that you're going to see lots of performances, array of performances from all over the world. My dance group will be there as well. The dance group that I run are current uni students, all female, and we're called Nyarangara, which means passionate. And you'll see some dij, you'll see capoeira. I believe there's going to be another Indigenous dance group. You'll see some hip hop, maybe a little Bollywood. I think some of the events and the sessions and the dance spaces for that are still to be confirmed, but you will not be disappointed with the array of diversity and cultural diversity that you have witnessed.
Then, of course, the actual fair itself on Thursday. So I'd imagine that would be a nice chance to sample some foods, which you were kind of did with the food you didn't bring in today.
So you will have the opportunity at the immersion just to sample a few small snacks as well. But, on the Cultural Awakenings Fair, bring your own plate. I mean, if you do come and you're a uni student, because you will be filling that plate several times. I go to this event every year. I have not missed it for, I think, 4 years currently. And that Pakistani, that society, do they can put on a lovely feed.
Sounds like bring a doggy bag. Look, a lots of other things happening as well. It's the Cultural Awakenings Festival, Tuesday to Thursday, from Wollotuka Institute at the University of Newcastle. Tammy Small, thank you for your time. You better get back and get all ready for next week and the dancing. We've got some details on the festival up at our webpage, 2NURFM.com, and our morning show page. So have a look at that this morning. As always, 2NURFM, in touch with your community.